Good morning, everybody. Today we will study adenoceptor blocking drugs. Means those drugs which block adenoceptors like alpha receptors and beta receptors. And we will start with alpha blockers. Adenoceptor blocking drugs are drugs which selectively block the action of sympathomimetic amines by acting on either alpha or beta receptors or both of them and produce effects opposing to those which are produced by stimulation of these receptors by sympathomimetic amines. मतलब कि sympathomimetic amines जो हम लोग पीछे पढ़े हैं उसके एक्शन को जो ब्लॉक करता है by acting on alpha और beta receptors और opposite effect देता है वैसे drugs के बारे में हम लोग आज पढ़ेंगे. There are many drugs in the alpha blockers group and they have been classified in three groups. The first one is non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2 blockers. You know very well that alpha receptors have been divided into two, that is alpha 1 and alpha 2. So the first group is non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2 blockers. The second group is selective alpha 1 blockers and the third group is selective alpha 2 blockers. Among the non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2 blockers that have been further subdivided into two groups, that is reversible and irreversible. Among the irreversible alpha non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2 blockers are imidazoline derivatives which contains phentolamine and prolazoline, ergot alkaloids which consist of ergotamine and dihydroergotamine, and the third one is miscellaneous, that is labetalol and chlorpromazine. These all drugs are non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2 blockers. In the irreversible group, there is one drug that is phenoxybenzamine. Phenoxybenzamine is irreversible alpha 1, alpha 2 blocker, non-selective. Then the next group is selective alpha 1 blocker, and in this selective alpha 1 blockers there are many drugs, important drugs like prazosine, terazosine, doxazosine, tamsulosine, alpizosine and others. I repeat, selective alpha 1 blockers, prazosine, terazosine, doxazosine, tamsulosine and alpizosine. Now the third group is selective alpha 2 blocker. The second one selective alpha 1 blocker. First was non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2. Second was selective alpha 1 blocker and the third group is selective alpha 2 blocker. And in this there is only one drug, that is nohimbine. You can find this classification in the book and study it. Now we'll come to reversible non-selective alpha blocker, means alpha 1 and alpha 2, both non-selective. The first drug is phentolamine and this is an imidazoline derivative. The mechanism of action is it completely blocks the effects of noradrenaline at both alpha 1 and alpha 2 adrenergic receptors. Means it blocks the effects of noradrenaline at both alpha 1 and alpha 2 receptors. Since it is non-selective, It can also block 5-HT receptors, 5-hydroxytryptamine receptors, potassium ion channels, and can cause release of histamine from the mast cells. Then what are the pharmacological effects? Peripheral vascular resistance is reduced due to blockade of vascular alpha 1 receptor. You know, alpha 1 receptor when it is secreted causes vasoconstriction, which leads to increase in peripheral vascular resistance. Now, since the alpha 1 receptor is blocked, so peripheral vascular resistance will be reduced due to blockade of vascular alpha 1 receptor. Next is, there is increase in noradrenaline secretion from adrenergic nerve endings due to blockade of presynaptic alpha 2 receptors. Presynaptic alpha 2 receptors are blocked, so there will be increase in noradrenaline secretion from the adrenergic nerve ending. This may produce cardiac stimulation. Since the release of noradrenaline is increased, the presynaptic alpha 2 receptors are blocked, so there will be rise in the level of noradrenaline, and this will produce cardiac stimulation and may cause tachycardia, palpitation, and cardiac arrhythmia. Now, these are the pharmacological effects of phencolamine. Mode of administration, it is given intravenous. Onset of action is rapid, duration of action is short, and it is used during pheochromocytoma surgery. Diagnosis of pheochromocytoma and in hypertensive emergencies. Usually used for treatment of hypertensive crisis in case of clonidine withdrawal and Jig reaction. Clonidine, as you know, is an antihypertensive drug, and sudden withdrawal may cause hypertensive crisis, and in that case, to overcome the emergency, we can use this drug phencolamine. Side effects of these drugs are tachycardia, palpitation, arrhythmia, and it may precipitate myocardial infarction and angina. This is all about, in short, about phencolamine. And there is another drug in this book, that is tolazolin, which is similar drug, but tolazolin is now used rarely, not used now. Now, this drug phencolamine was from reversible alpha 1 alpha 2 blocker. Now we will take up the drug which is phenoxybenzamine, which is irreversible non-selective alpha blocker. It blocks both alpha 1 and alpha 2 receptors. It causes irreversible blockade by covalent bond to alpha receptors. The irreversible blockade is due to blockade of covalent bonds to the alpha receptor. It also inhibits reuptake of noradrenaline into the adrenergic nerve endings, and it is a non-competitive antagonist. Mode of administration is, it is given orally or by slow intravenous injection. Onset of action is slow, duration of action is long because of irreversible blockade of alpha receptor. Induction action will naturally be longer because there is irreversible blockage of alpha receptors. It is used in the treatment of pheochromocytoma only in the treatment of pheochromocytoma. Side effects are tachycardia, palpitation, postural hypotension, diarrhea, nasal stuffiness, and impotence is also one of the side effects. This is all about phenoxybenzamine. Just for revision, we'll take up in short vasomotor reversal of gait. We have already studied it. What happens there? Intravenous injection of adrenaline when we give causes rise in the blood pressure due to alpha effect, followed by prolonged fall due to beta 2 effect. It is administered after giving alpha blocker. If it is administered after alpha blocker is given, then only fall in blood pressure will be seen. That is due to its beta 2 effect. एडरेनालिन का इंजेक्शन हम लोग देते हैं तो क्या होगा, देयर विल बी राइज इन ब्लड प्रेशर ड्यू टू अल्फा इफेक्ट. उसके बाद बीटा टू इफेक्ट शुरू हो जाएगा तो क्या होगा, फॉल ऑफ ब्लड प्रेशर होगा. अगर हम लोग पहले अल्फा ब्लॉकर दे दें और फिर एडरेनालिन दें तो क्या होगा, देयर विल बी फॉल इन ब्लड प्रेशर दैट इज ड्यू टू बीटा टू इफेक्ट. दिस इज इन शॉर्ट सीन इन which is called vasomotor reversal of gait. Now, in pheochromocytoma, beta blockers are used to control cardiac manifestation. Beta blockers are used to control the cardiac manifestation. But it should not be given alone because this may result in unopposed alpha action and there will be severe hypertension. Beta blockers are used, but if it is used before giving alpha blocker, what will happen? There will be an opposed action of alpha receptors and there will be severe hypertension which may be fatal. So prior alpha receptor blocker is essential, must. If we are going to use beta blocker for in the treatment of pheochromocytoma, prior alpha blocker is not before giving beta blocker. This should be remembered. Then now we come to selective beta alpha 1 blocker. Selective alpha 1 blocker, and the drug here is prazosin. Last two drugs were non-selective alpha 1 and alpha 2 blocker. Now we are coming to selective alpha 1 blocker, and the drug here is prazosin. It is an extremely potent and highly selective alpha 1 receptor blocker and dilates arteriole more than the veins. There is fall in total peripheral resistance and blood pressure. Since alpha 1 receptor is dropped, so there will be decrease in peripheral vascular resistance and there will be fall in blood pressure. But no tachycardia. And this may cause first dose postural hypotension leading to fainting attack. We mean to say that if we give prazosin first dose, first time when it is taken, it may lead to complete blockade of alpha 1 receptor. There will be fall in peripheral vascular resistance. There will be decrease in blood pressure and it may lead to first growth postural hypertension and patient may faint, yes, fell down, fall down. So this is called first growth postural hypertension. As this drug prazosin has low affinity for alpha 2 receptor, so it produces less tachycardia. It produces less tachycardia. Because there is low affinity for alpha 2 receptor as compared to non-selective antagonists like fenfluramine, which blocks alpha 2 receptors also. It has no significant effect on renal function. It is a well tolerated drug and is associated with increase in high density lipoprotein, which is beneficial. So prazosin is a selective alpha 1 blocker and it causes decrease in total peripheral resistance, it causes decrease in blood pressure. First dose when given may lead to postural hypotension and there may be fainting attack, and it has another benefit that it increases high density lipoprotein level, which is beneficial. Pharmacokinetics. This drug is well tolerated orally. Only 50% of an orally administered drug is systemically available. Dose is 1 milligram thrice daily, which is started from a very low dose, 1 milligram thrice daily, which is increased up to 20 to 30 milligram per day. First dose is given at bedtime. Patient is warned that when you go to bed, you don't have to stand up. You take the drug, and because first dose may lead to postural hypotension and there may be fainting attack. So, its use in treatment of hypertension. We use this drug in treatment of hypertension. What are the side effects? First and foremost is first dose phenomena. Within 30 to 90 minutes of oral administration of prazosin, severe postural hypotension and syncopal or fainting attack may occur. You know the mechanism behind this. Alpha 1 receptors are blocked. There is decrease in total peripheral resistance. There will be hypotension, which will be severe, and if the person is erect or standing, it may cause postural hypotension and there may be syncopal or fainting attack. Therefore, what we do, what precaution we take, it is the first dose is given small, only 1 milligram. It is started with 1 milligram and it is advised to the patient to take it at bedtime and to remain in bed for several hours. After taking the drug, patient is asked to remain in bed for several hours. Don't stand up because first dose phenomena and postural hypertension and syncopal attack. Tolerance to this effect develops gradually. Other side effects are mild, like dizziness, palpitation, headache, lassitude, thakavat layega. Inhibition of ejaculation is another side effect. There may be inhibition of ejaculation. This is one of the side effects of prazosin. Now, the next drug in this group is terazosin. It blocks alpha-1A, alpha-1B and alpha-1B receptors. And its bioavailability is more. Plasma half-life is 12 hours and so the dose is 2 to 10 milligrams once daily and is used in benign prostatic hyperplasia. प्रोस्टेट इलाजमेंट बेनाइन प्रोस्टेट इलाजमेंट में हम लोग टेराजिसिन का यूज करते हैं. नेक्स्ट ड्रग इन दिस ग्रुप इज डॉक्साजोसिन. इज ऑल नो द सेलेक्टिव अल्फा वन ब्लॉकर. इट इज डॉक्साजोसिन इज द लॉन्गेस्ट एक्टिंग सेलेक्टिव अल्फा वन ब्लॉकर. इट हैज सिमिलर इफेक्ट टू प्राजोसिन एंड दिस ड्रग इज यूज इन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ बेनाइन प्रोस्टेटिक हाइपरट्रॉफी and hypertension. The next drug in this group is alpha-1-Josin, which is also selective alpha-1A, alpha-1B and alpha-1D receptor blocker. And it is an orally active drug taken once daily and the use is benign prostatic hypertrophy, BPH. These all drugs are nowadays used for the treatment of benign prostatic hypertrophy. You know, after certain age in elderly persons, the prostate enlargement, benign prostate enlargement occurs. Due to this, there are frequency of liquidation, urgency, nocturia, रात में पेशाब रहेगा बार बार, जल्दी जल्दी पेशाब रहेगा, urgency रहेगा. और तो ऐसे केसेस में हम लोग जब इन्वेस्टिगेट करते हैं तो फाइंड दैट द प्रोस्टेट इज इनलार्ज एंड प्रीवियसली ऑपरेशन वेयर डन बट नाउडेज आफ्टर द अराइवल ऑफ दीज ड्रग्स मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम दीज ड्रग्स आर यूज फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ बेनाइन प्रोस्टेटिक हाइपरट्रॉफी. अनदर ड्रग इन दिस ग्रुप इज टैम्सुलोसिन. It is an neuroselective alpha-1 blocker, alpha-1A. It reduces the resistance to urinary flow. It has little effect on the blood pressure. And it is neuroselective and it reduces the resistance to urinary flow. So this drug is used in cases of benign prostatic hypertrophy, usually in cases of normotensive cases, where the blood pressure is not raised, only there is prostate enlargement. Another group, selective alpha-2 blocker.